Hello and welcome to my channel. In today's video I want to talk about my DIY phono preamplifier. More specifically, I want to talk about its power supply. When I decided to build a phono preamplifier, I knew right from the start that I wanted the power supply to be separate from the phono preamp itself. The reason for this is very simple. Power transformers by definition create strong magnetic fields that can induce 50 or 60 Hz hum in small signal circuits. This is especially critical in phono preamps because the RIAA playback curve greatly amplifies low frequencies, which makes any mains hum extremely noticeable. The good news is that the strength of the magnetic field drops very quickly as the distance from the transformer increases. That's why an outboard power supply is the way to go for phono preamps. Another consideration is the amount of noise that the power supply produces. Remember, in phono preamps we are dealing with extremely low voltages. The output level of a typical digital source, such as a CD player, is about 2 volts. In comparison, the output level of a moving magnet phono cartridge is only about 5 mV or 400 times lower. Because of this, most phono preamps have about 40 dB of gain, which means that they amplify input voltage by 100 times. Of course, any noise from the power supply gets greatly amplified as well. There are many ways to make a very low noise power supply. The simplest way is to take a typical voltage regulator IC and filter its output using inductors. However, I decided to go a different route and opted for a low noise discrete voltage regulator PCB made by a small Bulgarian company called ATL Hi-Fi. These PCBs are made to order and I asked the manufacturer to make mine output plus and minus 15 volts. Of course, this PCB is useless on its own, it needs a transformer to supply it with the necessary input voltage. I opted for a small transformer with one 230 volt primary and two 15 volt secondary windings. I also needed an enclosure, a power switch, an input connector and an output connector. Warning, the next part of the video shows me working on a mains powered device. Mains voltage can be lethal, so please make sure that you are familiar with all relevant safety regulations in your country before you start poking around mains powered circuits. I will not be held responsible if you manage to electrocute yourself. At the moment, I'm building this power supply for my DIY phono preamplifier. I will build it inside this plastic enclosure here, and I already drilled necessary holes for mounting the PCB and for mounting the transformer, and also already installed some of the hardware, such as the connectors and the power switch here. So unfortunately, I think the box I've got is just a touch too small, so I will definitely fit everything inside, but it's just a bit tighter than I would like. And when I ordered this enclosure, I actually took a piece of paper, which is the same size as the inside dimensions of the box, and I made sure that both the PCB and the transformer will fit inside. Unfortunately, I did not account for the dimensions of the power switch, and I really wanted to use this switch here because this is the only mains rated switch that I have that is double pole, which means that I can switch both the live wire and the neutral wire at the same time. But it is very deep, and if I mount it inside the enclosure, it leaves literally no space for the power transformer. So I will use one of these switches instead. As you can probably see, it is quite a bit smaller than this switch. Unfortunately, it is only single pole, which means that I will be switching only the live wire with it. And at least here in Ireland, and we use polarized main plugs, which means that my live wire is always live and my neutral is always neutral. But if you live in a country which uses non-polarized plugs, then you definitely want to use a double pole switch as your power switch. Also, I wanted to show you why I absolutely hate working on projects that involve mains voltage. And that's not because I am afraid of mains voltage, I'm not. It's because I absolutely hate cutting out these large holes for IC power connectors. And in this case, I cut the hole with my Dremel and I use the file to smooth out its edges and to make it more presentable. But overall, I absolutely hate making these cutouts. I much prefer drilling small round holes for DC power connectors. As I already mentioned, I drilled the holes in the plastic bottom for mounting all the stuff inside the case. So these four holes are for mounting the PCB, and this large hole is for mounting the power transformer. And those holes in the corners are for rubber feet. I could have used stick-on bumpers, but I don't like them. I much prefer proper feet, so I will use these 4 feet. And actually, I think I will start assembling the power supply by installing this feet, because it would be difficult to do if I mount everything else to the case before installing the feet. Okay, the feet are installed, and I used just regular M3 machine screws and nuts to mount them. And next I will mount the PCB. As you can see, the PCB is mounted. I used these plastic screws to fix the standoffs in place, and then the PCB is fixed with nuts to the standoffs. And now I will mount the power transformer. Okay, the transformer is mounted. I hope that you can see it, but there is a big rubber washer on the bottom, then a transformer, then another rubber washer, then the metal cap. And the bolt goes through the hole in the bottom of the enclosure. And of course, I mounted the transformer in such a way that I can actually read which color corresponds to which secondary. I have wired the secondary side of the transformer, and now I need to wire the primary side. And the live wire will go to the power switch on the front panel, and the neutral wire will go to the IC connector on the rear panel. And I will also have to run a neutral wire from the IC connector to the power switch if I want the power indicator lamp in the switch to work. Okay, so I have everything connected. And I will definitely have to redo the wiring, because the box is just too small, and I will have to shorten this wire, for example. But what I wanted to show you is, if I turn it on, so the indicator lamp is glowing, as you can see. And if I take my multimeter here, so I get plus 15 volts on the positive side, and I get minus 15 volts on the negative side of the power supply. And now I wired the output of the power supply PCB to the connector, and I decided against shortening wiring here. Instead, I used a couple of cable ties to make sure that these wires do not get pinched by the sides of the enclosure. The power supply is assembled. I have put the screws in, and I must say that when it's all assembled together, this box really feels quite sturdy, so very nice quality. And for the output, I used one of those so-called aviation style connectors. And this one has 3 pins, because the power supply has 2 outputs, plus and minus 15 volts in addition to ground. And the nice thing about these connectors is that you cannot plug them in the wrong way. So as you can see, there is like a groove on this side, which mates nicely with the male connector. So they can only go in one way. And also, when they are plugged in, you can screw it all together, so it will not disconnect by accident. Now that my power supply is ready, in the next video, I will talk about the phono preamp itself.